your search, you have core values available to it. I mean, this thing is ready to rock and roll. All your company data is available. In addition, you've talked to Mashery, you've talked to Apigee, you've got a console set up, and because Twilio has a developer evangelist, that seems like a good idea, you've hired several developer evangelists. Now let's see what your API looks like. Flames. Your Sears. Let's go ahead and take a look at their developer portal here. Last time somebody posted in their first thread there, the first forum, was back in November of 2010. They got a little more action in the store locator post forum there, but not a lot. Sears has got a lot of data, a lot of products. I think it's actually a pretty good API, but they're just not getting much developer traction. So let's take a look at a real API. A real API does it. All right, Zappos, our Google group. Oh, wait. Our last post was June 13th, and there aren't really that many posts in there either. Most of them are real posts about happy hours. Which you should definitely do if you ever see one of these posts. Stop by the SF office for sure. But the point is, it's actually hard to get third-party developers for your API, whether you're Sears, with probably a very low tech rating for your user base, or Zappos, who, you know, our main customer is a older jogging iPad-only woman, so very high tech. Either way, it's hard to get third-party developers. So where do you look for developers to use your API? These are the people you're looking for right here. They love sandwiches. They love being in the same room together. And Flames. You already employ them. You are already paying them to work on the back end of your API, to work on your website, to work on everything else. So why don't you get them using your public API first before trying to recruit their party developers? So right now you are in CTO land, you're like, but what about the roadmap? We don't have time for that on the roadmap. We're going to have to push back Facebook integration, and we're going to have to push back redoing the reviews for the third time this year if we're going to do that. This is a picture I don't want to do with that. I just blew up my chair. So we're looking at the DAO, the API, how to look into your company and drive internal innovation. Come up with three bullet points we should look at. First, obviously, for the CTO and manager-minded like Rick out here, we have roadmap projects. So at Zappos, we have our mobile devices all run completely off our public API. There's no hidden back-end API that's top secret. They all run off the same API that other third-party developers use. And it was actually very beneficial when we were developing both the API and the iPad app, because it was pretty obvious early on what calls needed to be streamlined, what responses also needed to be returned in order to simulate the entire process from product browsing and exploration to checkout on mobile devices using API. Also, have third-party integrations. We integrated with the Season Desktop, and they use completely the Zappos API as well. And our SF office engages in what we call alternative shopping experiences. And they also use the API for all of their stuff. And anytime they need something added to the API, they give us a call. And we return 404. Just kidding. It's good stuff. Okay, so we have roadmap projects. So we have my personal favorite. Hackathon. Everybody here has probably been to a hackathon. That was a very patronizing statement. I'm sorry if you haven't been to hackathons, but you should. Zappos, like other tech companies, Facebook, LinkedIn, has hackathons. And we do ours every quarter, 36 hours, which comes up to be about 2 days. During those 2 days, you are free from your manager. You don't have any tasks, you don't have to look at your GRQ, you don't have to look at your email, nobody can schedule meetings for you. You don't even have to come into work as long as you're actually working on your hackathon. And you can make whatever you want. So usually we end up forming up into teams. Somebody has a great idea, like making a dating website based off the Zappos personnel registry. That wasn't a great idea. Somebody has a great idea, like installing sensors in the men's restroom so we can tell when the bathroom stalls are occupied or unoccupied, so you can streamline your activity during the day. So you gather into groups, you have 36 hours to hack. At the end of the 36 hours, as a GM, at the end of the 36 hours, we have company-wide demos where everybody from the phone support, our CLT team, to Tony and the take a look at all apps, either present them, demo them, it's quite the madhouse. After that, we do voting, and there was somebody, a really great developer, made an online voting app for this last time. And then after the voting, of course, we have winning. You can see here these gentlemen with the great walking hands. They're holding iPads and iPhones demoing the toilet app. So you can see that stalls 1 and 2 are unavailable, while the urinal and little pro tip, that one is the handicapped, which would actually fit 2 or 3 people. it was a pretty amazing hackathon project. So other hackathon projects that have come out and have actually gone live on our site, or are in the process of going live, are a search similarity project, which lets you specify a product and then receive different products that are similar to that. Having that available through the API before it was available as a site feature, and helped the developers get it done a lot faster. Or would have if they had known it was available through the API. Instead, they went through the back end and hard-coded everything they needed to get the search similarity working. It actually took them quite a bit longer than it would have if they would have known about the API call they could have used. So we need to do a little more evangelism inside the company to let people know what features are available through the API. This is Zixel World. It was a HTML5 game based on the idea of. Hey, does everybody remember Final Fantasy games? You see a show of hands? Yes, Final Fantasy. So nerds have been shopping online since King's Quest and Final Fantasy, right? Before our website, before e-commerce, we were going through, talking to the potion vendor, clicking down 100 times, and then clicking up 99 times to buy 99 potions. I mean, it's awesome. So this was, Final Fantasy started shopping to Zappos and enticed more. So it's putting quests, like, so they made each store was an individual building, each apartment, I should say, was an individual building on the map, and you get a quest to go buy a certain item, you have to go to that store and fight monsters along the way and obtain the magic lucky brand cowboy boot for your out-of-town base. This is a feature that's live right now. You can log into Zappos and look in your cart. I don't know what it's actually called, but it lets you just hover over your order number to see every item that was in that order instead of having to kind of click through and then back, through and back until you find which order you wanted to replace because you love your shoes so much. This one is my order, so you can see I really like women's shoes and children's shoes. Right? Pro tip, I've never actually ordered shoes on that. This is a great one. It's called Patron Smash. I guess I'm making you all of these. So this is a kind of an API, a console browser bar API that lets you tailor your search call with terms and using our multifaceted filters and facets and see the real time what the responses you get. So if you were trying to create an app that does search, want to grab a certain kind of product, you can use this to grab that. And this was the winner of our internal developer contest by Apple. That guy we won me is awesome, Michael Piescher, for this presentation. So we had three ways to do the API to Apple, and honestly, only two bold ones. Never really seen this class. So we're not done. All right, so what are the benefits of having your internal developers work on your public API? First and foremost, we find that we get a lot of bugs are found, behaviors that weren't expected or aren't quite right, found and fixed before we ever get them put out to third-party developers, which I'm sure our other developers appreciate. Also, Apple is an expert at finding errors in our documentation and being able to fix them. And there's a ton of code and sample apps that are written that can be put out for people to see. Yesterday, Crystal demoed Spirit Dancer, which is a great little app that takes all of the product images and you can make any of our models dance in spirit goods. The spirit goods are furry and probably wearing it in. So there are a lot of other very positive benefits to having your developers work on that. Also, the benefit is anything developed against your public API internally is going to get to get out live to the site a lot faster. So the reason is because your API is to read directly off the slide without looking at it. It's rock solid, tested by your keywords. Right here, a keyword team is engaged in managing that file. That's an older one. Very professional QA team. You should see it. So the other, so if your QA team tests it, you know it's good. It's nuclear hardened. What's it called? You say nuclear hardened.
Nuclear.
SysOps teams. You know, if it goes down, it's coming back up very quickly because they're monitoring. And then, and also it's penetration proof thanks to your security. Security team. We have one member of the Zappos security team in the attendance here. They are always basically delayed on releases so that they can try to hack all the code before we get out, and we appreciate that. So the question is, what will your devs make if you turn them loose on your public API? Well, the first thing they're going to do is they're going to, if you give them time to work on something on their own, they're going to solve problems they have every day, like PC, picture them, you know, that problem. Also, they will find new ways for your customers to use your service. So, for example, Zappos, we have a project that somebody's working on called ZTV, which takes all our reviews and turns them into like a shopping experience for a different way of browsing products instead of having to go and drill down to the taxonomy. So, whatever you think or your business site thinks is the best way to do your to present your service, your developers probably have another idea that might be just as good. Most important thing, though, is developers know what they need to hear. They need to see that one guy from accounting come around the corner and ask for a report. Or they need to have the one business user come back every Tuesday and complain about the same project. So if you give them time on their own way from roadmap projects to hackathons, they're probably going to find either make tools or fix those problems. Like maybe what you would have your developer do is write a certain report. What they would rather do is write an entire framework so the user can generate reports on their own. You never even thought they're capable of it because you're just going to need them to change around the HTML pieces and stuff like that. They're going to eliminate hassles because, let's face it, I have five bosses, and my only rule is I have to be a hassle. So don't be afraid to make mistakes when you're working with your API and your internal developers. One of the things that's been amazing about Zappos is exception to that rule is to don't be afraid to make mistakes. Do whatever I feel is right and is going to help. And if I do something wrong, then we'll talk about it. But it's probably not going to be fine. So I'm not going to miss the case. Like the time I was in the SF office seeing the Bohemian Rhapsody really loud and it was shushing me because he was trying to have a business meeting.
It's on YouTube. Search for it.
If I had any time left over, I would be seeing the Bohemian Rhapsody. So, we are the Zappos API team, Crystal and I, and we like to follow us on Twitter. Also, I showed a lot of pictures with just kind of stuff that happened inside of Zappos. It looks like it's awesome to work there. It is. If you want to work there, you can. Just let us know. We'll let you know so you can follow us. And that's Flames.
Yeah. I don't want to stop recording.